first start with this one, and 1 over big phi d square big phi over d square phi is equal or d phi square, this is equal to 0. Now this differential equation, sorry, this is not equal to 0, but this is equal to minus m square. So minus m square, and this implies that d square big phi over d phi squared is equal to minus m square phi. Now I know how to solve such a differential equation. This is the easiest one, and we know that the solution of this is in the form of exponential. So I can write that the solution of this, for the moment I will ignore constant here in the solution, because that constant I will put here. This implies that big phi is a function of phi is equal to any constant, and for the moment I am taking that constant equal to 1, because I will incorporate that constant here. Ultimately these two constants will multiply and it will give another constant, so I will keep that constant there, and I will write that the solution of this equation phi of phi is e plus minus I m phi. Now this can be written in terms of cos and sine as well, but I am writing in exponential. So this is the solution, and if I want to put this plus minus, that the m will have its value is plus minus. So then I will write that the solution of this equation is phi equals e I m phi, while m values will run from plus minus both. So now is I know that phi is running from 0 to 2 pi. So if I consider a sphere, then on any point of the sphere this will go like this, while theta will go like this, just like is the longitude and the altitude. So phi is going this way. Now the value of the wave function, this wave function phi, its value on any value of phi will remain the same as on 2 pi as well. So I can write that if I consider my wave function big phi, then its value at any angle phi, at any value phi, will be the same if I rotate this wave function to 2 pi. Then this value will remain the same, because 2 pi rotation will get me back there on this point, because this is the range of my phi. So I will return back to this position, and now if I put here in the solution that e I m phi will be equal to e I m and phi plus 2 pi, then it will give me the value of m, that what it is. So putting this value will give us that e I m phi is equal to e I m phi plus 2 pi. So I can write this I m phi plus 2 pi, and this I can write is E I m phi into E I m 2 pi. So these two can be cancelled. E I m phi is cancelling with E I m phi, and I will get that E I m 2 pi is equal to 1. Now, if I expand this thing with the help of Euler formula, then I know that EIX is equal to cos X plus I sin X. So this implies that EIM 2 pi is equal to cos 2 pi plus I sin 2 pi. And I will put the value m with it as well. So here is m and here is m. So this is, I know that cos 2 pi, if n is equal to 0, then, and this is equal to 1. So if n is equal to 0, then I will have, because I know that m is possessing both plus and minus value, so I will only go for the m 0 value. For example, 0 here, so cos 0 is 1 and sin 0 is 0, so it is satisfied. Similarly, when m is 1, then cos 2 pi is 1 and sin 2 pi is 0, so again it is satisfied. So m is an integer. This tells us that m is an integer and it possesses both positive and negative values, including 0 as well. So I can write that m is equal to 0 plus minus 1 plus minus 2 plus minus 3 and so on. I can see here that can m have any non-integer value? For example, I consider half, then m is half, so cos 2 pi by half, it will become cos pi. This will become sin pi. Sin pi is 0, but cos pi is minus 1, so the equation is not satisfied, and thus the mathematics tells us that m will be an integer only and it can have both plus and minus values as well. We can satisfy the plus minus values here. Whatever the value plus minus is here, minus will come out because sine is an odd function and it will become 0 for all the plus minus values. While here cos minus theta is equal to cos theta, so it will not affect this thing, and we say that it will have both these values. So the constant m that we supposed here, we don't know this constant yet, the reality of this constant yet, but we came to know about this constant, that this constant is an integral constant and it possesses both plus and minus values. Now I come to the second equation, which is the theta dependent equation, and I can write that sine theta, if I multiply this theta with m square here, then I will write that sine theta curly d by d theta d over d theta sine theta and d big theta by d theta plus l and l plus 1 sine square theta and theta big theta will be multiplied with this. So let me take that big theta common and minus m square, this equal to m square, so it will go there and become minus m square, and this is multiplied with big theta here, and this is equal to zero. So I'm having now this equation, and this equation is called the associated Legendre equation, and the solution of this Legendre equation is that big theta, a function of theta, means the wave function which is depending on theta, any constant which we will have to determine, and p L index in M index of cos theta. Here we will have to note one thing, that x in plane polar coordinates, x is equal to r cos theta. So here, if I consider a unit circle here, then on a unit circle in the plane polar coordinates, not the spherical polar, then on a unit circle r is equal to 1, and I am having x equal to cos theta. So this is to be noted, that here this cos theta is actually x in our Cartesian coordinates. This is the associated Legendre equation, and this is a polynomial solution of this equation. Now we here at BS level, we will not derive that how this equation is solved to give this solution, but for those who are interested, I am providing a link of the classical electrodynamics lectures in which we have derived that the associated Legendre equation will have the solution, this one. So here L is a positive, L is a positive integer. It is not having non-negative, it is not having negative values, and this PLM of x, our PLM of cos theta, I am now writing this in terms of x, is equal to, is actually defined is this, which comes out to be the solution 1 minus x square, and the positive value of m divided by 2 d over dx, and this is having also part of m absolute, means only the positive value, and pl of x, where pl of x are called the Legendre polynomial. So the Legendre polynomial and plm of x is the associated Legendre polynomial. This pl of x is the lth Legendre polynomial, and I can write the value of this is PL of x is equal to 1 over 2 to the power L and L factorial d over dx to the power L and x squared minus 1 to the power L. So these are the Legendre polynomials. Now let me clarify this. For details you can consult the classical electrodynamics videos, but here let me tell you that when we consider that our wave function is azimuthally symmetric, means it is not depending on phi, then this m will become equal to zero, and the solution of this equation will be the Legendre polynomial. But when we consider that our wave function is not azimuthally symmetric, That is means azimuthal angle wise it is different on the sphere. Then this equation we call the associated Legendre polynomial, and of this Legendre polynomial we will have to take the mth derivative as well. So while this is the balancing factor here, so this Legendre polynomial I can derive few values of this. For example, L is any positive integer. So here L is a positive integer means that L values can be 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. So first start with the value L equals 0. When L is 0, I will have P naught of x, and P naught of x will be 1, 1, 2 to the power 0 will be 1, and 0 factorial is 1, d over dx, and here for L, so it will also become 1, and this is x square minus 1 to the power 0, so this will also become 1, and we will ultimately have that p naught of x is equal 1. Now if L is equal to 1, then we will have p1 of x, and p1 of x will be 1 over 2 power 1, so it will become 2, L 1 factorial, so it is 1, d over dx to the power 1, and x squared minus 1 to the power 1 as well. Now when I differentiate this with respect to x, it will become 2x. 2, 2 will cancel and I will have only x here. So this one is equal to 1 and this is equal to x, and if I convert this into theta, then x is equal to cos theta. So I will write this is, this is equal to cos theta. When L is equal to 2, means the constant value is 2, then the Legendre polynomial P2 of x will become 1 over 2 to the power 2 and multiplied with 2 because 2 factorial is 2, and d over dx to the power 2, and here x squared minus 1 and to the power 2. So I will have this thing equal to, I can further simplify this, and let me do this thing directly. This will become 1 over 2, so 1 over 4 into 2. This is d square over dx square of x square minus 1 whole square. So I will have this thing equal to, if I a square minus b square, if I expand this one and I do simplification, I will get that this is half and 3x square minus 1. So we have this thing